Hey guys, I wanted to make a quick video to show people how to get Flashpoint working again in 2021. I've seen quite a few people talk about Project Nexus Classic over the last couple of months, mainly talking about how the game's glitching and basically just trying to get it to work again. In this video, I'm going to be talking over the options of both the Newgrounds player and Blue Maxima's Flashpoint as well. Kind of talk about the pros and cons of both. So I'm here on the page for Project Nexus Classic. So Newgrounds switched to using Ruffle, which is a Flash emulator. And the problem with Ruffle is that it's still in development and not all content is going to work for it, which is why a lot of bugs come about. You'll notice if I play this, it will take a while to load, and B, some of the menu interfaces won't work, and various other things. But it's actually quite an easy fix. You can identify that it's using Ruffle based on a couple of factors. And this is still loaded, so it's not going to show you. But basically, oh, there we go. So yeah, if you're right clicking on the Kickstart, if you're right clicking on the background of the game, it will show you that you're using Ruffle and you're going into full screen, exit full screen, all of that. But as you can see, it looks a little bit weird already if you're familiar with this game. So let's get Flash Player working using the Newgrounds player. So the first thing we want to do, if you go to your account settings and scroll down to Flash Options, and you'll see a link to the Flash Player. And as it states here, February 18th, 2021, Newgrounds Player will now edit flashmms.config file for Windows. This was the file that was basically causing Flash Player not to work. The Newgrounds Player automatically corrects that file and allows Flash Player to continue running on Windows 10. So let's open this up. Next, you can choose where you want to install it. I'm fine with the default. Installation complete. I'm not sure if this updates the... That doesn't. So as you can see, we've installed the Flash Player, but nothing's showing up. So on the Flash options on your Newgrounds account, you want to use Newgrounds Player for Flash, and I presume you have to also... Yeah. You want to disable Ruffle Flash emulation if possible. For now, when we do it, we get a different screen. Launching Newgrounds Player, and we'll have a little pop-up here, and yes, we want to open that. And now, as you see, it looks completely different. This is the authentic Flash experience, which should be completely bug-free. And, very now. But yeah. Simple. Yep. All that good stuff. You can go into full screen mode in a Flash Player as well, use escape. So that's one way to get the basic Flash Player working again. I would recommend this because I believe that I'm not sure if it states, but I'm fairly sure all of the Newgrounds achievements should still be usable using the Newgrounds player. I believe. Not 100% on that, but either way. I'm using a virtual machine first. And as you can also tell, you can also use movies. So Madness 4 here, loads as normal. Eventually. There you go. All the options still work. That's all good. And obviously you can still switch to the video side as well. And back to Flash. So movies are fine. Games, you're probably going to have to go back into here, Flash options, to toggle Ruffle on and off if there's a certain game that does work 100% with Ruffle. I would probably recommend using Ruffle. But let's talk about the second option. This is Blue Maximus Flashpoint, and it's a piece of software that I get. Well, it's something I hear about a lot. I'm not a huge fan of this concept, mainly because Newgrounds Player already sorts this for you. But I'm going to tell you the two different options that you have with this. I would personally recommend using Flashpoint Infinity. The difference being between these two is that the Ultimate version basically comes packaged with every Flash game they have archived. And as it says, it's 532 gigabytes in size. Whereas the Flashpoint Infinity only downloads the games that you personally want to play. So as a secondary option, I'd say that it's definitely worth knowing about. So yeah, you can go to the website. Basically, it's a basic installer, and you can basically just search for the game that you're after and install it from there. But in terms of playing it straight out of Newgrounds, the Newgrounds player works perfectly and it's very easy to use. Thank you.